Everybody, this is Rich. What we're gonna cover today is emergency braking, that's emergency stopping, and brake and escape. Welcome to the channel. I'm Rich from Boots and Jeans Riders. Gonna show you this little small thing that we have set up so you can get out in the lot and practice. Doesn't require a lot of cones, but we're gonna show you how we do it. And it's already set up, and I'm gonna walk you through it right quick. Show you what the course is we have set up for today. Here we have a green cone, and 20 feet down the road, we have the end of the cone with cones in the middle. We just put a lot of cones so you can see it on video. And the purpose of this is, I'm gonna be riding, getting the bike up to 20 miles an hour. The minute my front tire hit that green cone, I should be applying pressure to my front and rear brake at the same time in order to stop 20 feet later before I run into the rear of the vehicle or obstacle is ever here. Then the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna talk about going around that obstacle where you brake and escape the object. We have the obstacle set up 5.5 feet. If somebody were to slam on their brakes in front of you, you can get around them. Not to mention, if someone making a left turn in front of you, when you start braking, you release those brakes, and most likely, you're gonna go to the left. And I'm gonna explain why I go to the left around objects more than going to the right. Now, one thing I wanna mention is about your braking. That front brake is critical. So when you're braking, do not squeeze that thing. You know, just like you learn in basic class, if you took a basic class, or all the advanced classes teach you these also, you just want to squeeze on that brake, gradual pressure, and you can use the rear brake at the same time. That way you get 100% stopping power. Now, if you have ABS, obviously, you're probably not going to lock your brakes up, depending on how fast you're going. In this demonstration, I'm only going to go 20 to 25 miles an hour to show that you can stop in 20 feet at 20 miles an hour. So be careful on your braking. Get out there and practice this. Then I'm going to explain why I go to the left more than I go to the right. Here we go. First time I'm going to do the emergency braking. This representing that someone has slammed on their brakes in front of you, or someone has come out and you need to come to a complete stop. So what I'm gonna do is get up about 20 miles an hour. I'm in a parking lot, I won't go no faster than that, but this is the procedure, work at everything. The minute my front tire hit that green cone, I'm gonna start my braking. 20 miles an hour, green cone. I should not be in front or running into that thing. So I actually stopped at less than 20 feet. One of the other things you need to remember is, as you're doing this, once you come to a complete stop, you need to be checking your mirrors to make sure that a vehicle is not coming up behind you immediately. So I'm gonna do it once again. Now, this is only 20 foot setup, but you know, when you're on the freeway or driving on the street, you're not going 20 miles an hour. I'm just doing 20 miles an hour for this demonstration, showing that at 20 miles an hour, you can actually stop 20 feet without running into rear anything. But you should be scanning and preparing. Okay, this car looked like I see the brakes on. I can start stopping from back here long before I get there. And then I can stop here, even though that car stopped. Now, this is for emergency braking, sudden stops. All of a sudden, it's like that, oops, let me go on and apply these brakes. And find your parking lot, practice this. The more you practice, the less you have to think of it, and the reaction become quicker. And one of the things you should be doing, especially if you can anticipate this, you're anticipating that car about to turn left in front of you, cover that brake. Cover that brake right here and be set up, ready to go. So here we go. got the brake up. That was even better. Although I don't think I made it up to 20 miles an hour there. I think it was about 15 miles an hour. So the next demonstration will be brake and escape, where you brake, release the brakes, and escape hitting the object. And then I will explain why I escaped to my left more than my right. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is we're going to go into the brake and escape, or swerving around an object, obstacle avoidance, whatever you choose to call it. And then I will explain why I do 90% of my practice in obstacle avoidance going to the left. So with the same principle, get about 20 miles an hour. 20 miles an hour, get right here, brake, release the brake, go around, come back into your travel, and you are set. One more time. I'm going around for another run. Now, the reason I practice these things so much is because I do not want to have to think of nothing when I see a vehicle stopping in front of me or invading my space, cutting in to the left, making a left turn in front of me, or perhaps a vehicle running a stop sign coming from my right and or left. It doesn't matter. So here I go. I'm at 20 miles an hour. Coming. Oh snap, vehicle cut me off. Press back in direction of travel, and you are set. Now, we're going to keep it short, keep it right there, but I'm going to explain to you why I choose to go to my left more than my right. Okay, here's the example. I'm riding down the street. Riding down the street, a car decides to come from that lane, turn left in front of me. By the time I hit my brake and start my avoidings, he's halfway through and I'm just going toward the rear of his car. That way, I'm not T-boning a person. And if I go to the right, most likely I will run right in front of him and he will hit me. That's the first reason. The second reason is, I'm gonna go around again and give you an example. And in the example, I will stop so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, coming around. I'm right in here. I'm riding here. And I go right here. And when I decide to go left to avoid the obstacle, I do not want to run over the double yellow line right here, risking coming into oncoming traffic. This is one of the reasons why when I'm coming to intersections and I'm riding, I normally ride in the left track, and that's a whole different video. I would do a video on lane positioning, and I will switch over to the right track when I'm coming up to anything like an intersection where I have the right of way. Just in case somebody decides to turn left in front of me, I will ride in the right track to give myself some maneuverability room in order to go around to my left. So example would be, if that's an intersection there, I'm riding in the right track. And as I'm riding in the right track, if somebody turning left invaded my space and I have to go this way, I want to have enough room to go around without, once again, going over that double yellow line. And that concludes this. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And when you subscribe, go ahead and hit that notification bell so you can be notified when Boots and Jeans Riders put up more videos like this. And also, put some stuff in the comments below. This is a fairly easy one to set up. We had emergency braking, squeezing that brake, putting pressure on the rear brake also so you can get 100% of your braking. And the second one was brake and escape. Brake, release those brakes, go around an object that's in your way. That's all we have for now. For Boots and Jeans Rider, remember, ride long, ride hard, ride strong, and most importantly, ride safe. Get out there and practice. Set it up. Peace.